Hey there everybody and welcome. I'm David Dev and in this tutorial we're going to be creating a WebSocket client on Godot and connecting it to a WebSocket server on Python. So I'm just going to go over a quick demo here. First of all, I'm going to just type in hello world, and if you click send, you're going to see that the message was sent to the server. As you can see, message from client hello world, and also the server just sent the same message back to the client and say receive data from server, I've got your message, hello world. So this is a basic echo server and client implementation. In this tutorial I'm going to be going over everything. If this video gets up to 100 likes, I am going to make a chat app completely with Godot and Python. So if you like that, stay tuned and I'll see you after the intro. What do we do first? So this tutorial is going to be really simple. So I'm just going to click other node here, and I'm just going to add the default node. I'm going to rename this to server. Just know that whatever you name this doesn't really matter. And I'm going to add a child of this line edit, and also a child of the node again, a button. The last node I'm going to add is the rich text label, and that's just going to be printing out the messages that are being sent. So I'm going to increase the size of this a bit, put it down here, increase the size of the line edits just to fill out some space there. And the last thing is the button. I'm going to drag it down and just increase the size. So then the text on the button is going to be send, because this is what we'll be using to send the messages. We're going to leave this one blank and we have our debug here. So that's pretty nice. We're going to save it and we're going to add a script to the server. So you just add a script there. And in here, we're going to first of all make a variable called client, and it's going to be equal to WebSocket client.new. After that, we want to make a URL, so we say var URL, and it's going to be equal to ws:// localhost and on port 5000. So make sure you remember this for whatever port you use here. You can use 3000, 8000, many different ports you can use. But for this tutorial, I'm going to use 5000, and make sure you have this ws in front here, just saying this is a WebSocket. So the next thing is on the ready function, we're going to create a variable called error, and it's going to be equal to client.connect to URL and URL. So we're going to try to connect to this URL. This is where our server is going to be running now. We're going to go into that in a second. But for now, just create this variable and try to connect to the URL. So we say if error is not equal to OK, then we want to first of all set _process to false, and we want to print unable to connect. Hopefully we are done with all that. And on the process function _process, then we're going to just call client.poll. So this is basically just going to say every time just ask the server whether it's still connected, basically. So that's why if we are not able to connect, we want to set process to false, because we will not be able to even poll in the first place. So with that done, before we even connect to the client, we want to connect the data receive signal to a function that we're going to make now, data receive. So this is going to be called whenever the server sends a message. So I'm going to make that function now, func data received, and it's not going to take any parameters in there. And now to get the payload, I'm just going to say var payload. So we just create a new variable, and it's going to be equal to client.get_peer, and we're going to get the peer 1, because that's going to be the server at every point in time. So the server always has an ID of 1. Then we're going to get_packet dot get string from utf8. Then I think that should be all we need to do. We don't need to pass it as JSON or anything, because this is Python. Python doesn't even allow you to send JSON objects to a WebSocket, at least the WebSocket module that we're going to be using. So with all this done, we're going to rename this rich text label here to debug and go back to the script, and we're just going to say debug dot text plus equals to got message from server, and we just say plus payload here. Just to give this a little bit of space, I'm going to add a colon and a space after it. Then the next thing we want to do is to add a function that is going to be able to send messages. So we're just going to say func_send_message. You don't really need the underscore. And this is going to take in message. Remember, this is not a built-in function or anything. It's us that is just creating this function right now. So to send a message, you're going to do client.get_peer, and we'll get the first peer, that's the server again. Then we say dot put packet, and now we say json dot print, and in brackets we're just going to put in the message here. So MSG, and last thing is we're going to convert it to UTF-8. Put that as a function. And sorry, my bad. This to UTF-8 is actually meant to be inside here. So make sure you have two brackets closing at the end, just to be sure. So it's quite hectic and quite long, but this is actually the way to send messages with WebSockets. But we have to call this send message at some point. So we connect from the button signals on the press signal. Then we just want to send. Which message are we sending? Yeah, the line edit the text. So whatever text is in the line edit, just send it. So I'm open here in Sublime Text, and this is where we're going to be coding the Python we're going to be using. So create a file in your laptop called ws.py, websocket.py, whatever you want to name it, but make sure it has the .py extension, and that's where we're going to be coding stuff. And you can also open Notepad if you want. So before we begin, I want you to make sure you have Python installed. So what we're going to be importing here is WebSockets. So in order to install that, you can just say pip install WebSockets. And yeah, just have a W there, WebSockets. So when you click enter on that, it's just going to install. Make sure you have your internet on. But mine is already installed, as you can see, requirement already satisfied. So I'm going to close that out. And first thing we're going to import is async IO and WebSockets. Make sure you have these two things imported, and we're going to start. Then we're going to make a function, an asynchronous function, and it's going to have in two variables, which is WS or WebSocket or whatever, and a path. So now an asynchronous function is basically just going to say, there are some things in this function that are going to take some kind of time, so you have to wait for them before you continue. So that's just basically what it's saying. So next thing is, we're going to make an asynchronous for loop. And this is just going to say for message in WS, so for all the messages that that person sent, then we want to do something. So first thing we want to do with the message is we want to decode it to UTF-8. So the Godot by default is going to send it in bytes form, and it's Python's job to decode it. So that's why we say message equals message that decode UTF-8. Then the next thing is we want to just print out message from client and the message the client sent. The last thing we want to do is we want to await ws.send got your message. So as I said, it's going to wait for some things to happen. So this is just going to basically say send it back to the person that sent the message that, okay, we got your message, and send back the message, just to clarify. So with all that done, we are almost done. The last thing will be to start the server. As you can see, start server here is going to be equal to websocket.serve server. And that's this server here is just the server function up here, and local on localhost and port 5000. Remember, this port has to be the same with the ports over here. After that, we just want to print server started, just so that we can confirm. And async IO is going to handle the fact that the server should be running forever, basically. So as you can see, get event loop run until complete start server. So it's going to try to run the server until it's complete. And when it's completed, it will just start again, as you can see here, run forever. So we're going to save this, and you're going to go to the path that you saved, to see your ws.py file. Mine is over here in my game directory. So I'm just going to double click it to open. And if you see server started here, then you have done everything successfully. So we're going to minimize this to run the Godot game here. And over here, you're going to see if you just type in something like tutorial complete, then we just send it. As you can see, got message from server tutorial complete, and over here got message from client tutorial complete, basic echo server. And I also wanted to say, in future tutorials I'm going to be doing some Python tutorials, and I'm just hoping you like them. And for the last thing I want to show you before you go, there are many other signals that you can connect. As you can see, connection closed, error established, just so that you can know if your server is running and all that stuff. You can also check in the documentation. You just use control and click this WebSocket client here and go over to signals. You can see how all the signals are called and all that stuff. So I think that is all. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time. Smash subscribe, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.